والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, we send praises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, creator of the heavens, and we send peace and blessings to the Prophet Muhammad and to all of the messengers who came from the beginning of time. And we begin in the greeting words of the righteous, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah Azza wa Jal for this opportunity to be of the believers, to be fasting in this blessed month of Ramadan. Ramadan is a time of great mercy. Ramadan is a time of forgiveness. But in Ramadan, there are gems of wisdom. There are secrets of knowledge that believers today need to begin to unlock. It is no longer enough for Muslims to practice Islam only with the rituals of Islam. Not only should we fast, but we should begin to ask the questions, why are we fasting? Not only should we pray, but we should ask the questions and know, why do we pray? Why do we go to Hajj? Why do we eat halal foods? We should ask these questions in order to be able to explain this to the younger generation and also to give this message to the people of the planet. The month of Ramadan is a blessed time. It is a time when the closeness that the believer has to the Creator of the heavens and the earth is a source of guidance. And we have learned that the reason for fasting is for taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to us, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. O you who believe, fasting has been prescribed on you as it was prescribed on those who came before you in order that you would have consciousness, in order that you would have taqwa, you would have the fear of Allah, and you would hope in the mercy of Allah. As we go further into chapter 2, Surah Al-Baqarah, this was verse 183. If we continue on, once we have the theme of taqwa, we begin to see in the revelation, other verses are revealed. In verse 185, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. The month of Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed as a guidance for mankind, with sure signs of guidance, with the criteria to distinguish truth from falsehood. So in this verse, we see that Allah tells us that it is in this month, in the month of Ramadan, it is the time when the Quran was revealed as a guidance to humanity and as clear signs from the guidance and from the Furqan. So after the word taqwa, we see the word Furqan coming in. Many translators have translated this word as meaning a criterion. It is a way to separate truth from falsehood. But we need to look into this. We need to unlock one of the secrets of this month, that this Furqan, a recurring theme that comes throughout this month, there is great wisdom in the revelation of this word. If we turn to Surah Al-Anfal, verse 29, in verse 29 we see that it is revealed, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا وَيُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ ذُو فَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah has revealed, O you who believe, if you fear Allah and you keep your duty to Him, He will grant you a furqan. He will grant you a criterion and release you of your sins and forgive you, and Allah is the Lord of great bounty. So we see in this verse an extension of the meaning. In verse 183, Allah is telling us, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that you are fasting in order that you would have taqwa, in order that you would have the consciousness of Allah. You would fear Him and you would hope in His mercy. As we go on further into the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we see in Surah Al-Anfal, if you have taqwa, in taqullaha, if you have the consciousness of Allah, if you keep your taqwa, then Allah will make a furqan for you. Allah will make a criterion and separate truth from falsehood. One of the great imams, Imam al-Shawkani rahimahullah, in his Fath al-Qadir, he looked at this word furqan in a number of ways. And he informed us, based on the knowledge of the texts, that furqan can mean thabat al-qulub, wa quwwat al-basair, wa husn al-hidayah. Three important elements. Number one, thabat al-qulub. That this furqan strengthens the hearts. It makes your heart firm. Secondly, it gives you quwwat al-basair, it gives you power in your sight. Or you could even say, it gives insight into the issues. And finally, it gives husn al-hidayah, it gives the best of guidance. And so this furqan is of crucial importance to the Muslims today. Because not only are we in desperate need of the consciousness of Allah to be with us in our economic life, our political life, our social life, our spiritual life, but we also need to seek that other stage, that our hearts become firm, that no matter what happens in the world, with the natural catastrophes that are going on, we accept the will of Allah Azza wa Jal. With the many upheavals happening in our societies, we recognize that these are signs going toward the Day of Judgment. But this furqan will give us thabat, will make our hearts firm in these times of catastrophes and these times of difficult. It would also give us quwwatul basair. It would help us to see inside of the matters. And we are in great need of this today, with technology being at such a point that people have the ability to make what is true seem false, and to make what is false seem as though it is true. So therefore we need power in our sight and our insight, that we can look at the issues in the world, understand the history in back of it, understand the motivations of people, put this in line with our tawhidic understanding, with the oneness of God, that we begin to look at the creation and the desires of people and what happens to people in this world in the light of the Creator, and then we can begin to see deeper into the issues around us, that we would be able to make the right decisions, that we don't go to one extreme or another extreme, but that we can be ummatan wasata. We could be that balanced nation that has the insight into the issues and makes the right decisions based upon the book of Allah and the sunnah of the last Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Finally, husn al-hidayah. Muslims today are in need of guidance. We need to be guided in our spiritual life. People today in many parts of the world are resorting to strange metaphysical activities in order to fill the vacuum of their lives. They talk to their ancestors. They go to magicians. They practice different actions in order to try to tell the future, to try to speak to ghosts and spirits in order to feel happiness within themselves, in order to be able to accept what is happening in this world. But by having the furqan, by having that criterion, then the believer is guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one might ask, how can you be guided? You're fasting, you're giving up food, you're giving up drink, you are controlling your sexual desires. How can this be a form of guidance? Again, we recognize the niyyah, the intention. This fast is being done for the Creator of the heavens and the earth. So therefore, the state of the body, the lack of food, the tiredness that one feels, sometimes a little bit dizzy, especially in very hot countries, this feeling that comes over the individual when it is done for Allah, connects that person with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the breaking of the fast comes, and the energy returns to the body, we say, Alhamdulillah. We thank and we praise Allah. He is the one who has given us this food. He is the one who has given us this drink. And we understand what it is like not to have food. So the next time we hear about a tsunami, or we hear about a flood, or we hear about a drought, it won't be difficult for us to take out zakat, to take out sadaqah, to give lillah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from our wealth, because we are guided towards this. So therefore fasting itself, the state of fasting in the month of Ramadan, gives the believers that ability to separate truth from falsehood. We separate greed from the ability to give. We separate our issues that are happening in society. We need that guidance in our economic life. We need to be able to run our businesses according to the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to be able to learn how to spend properly and to thank Allah for every blessing, every little bit of wealth that we have. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. We need husnul hidayah also in our social life, in our family life. The relationship of husband to wife should be one of love. The home should not be an arena of war, but the home should be a place of peace. The younger generation should not look at their parents as their enemies. They don't have to make a rebellion on their parents, but they should thank their parents. They should make dua. They should make prayers for their parents. And they should do whatever they can to make the life of their parent easy, as their parents did for them when they were young. So we need guidance in our social life. The young people today being bombarded with technology, with colors, with lights, with sounds, attracted to drinking of alcohol and the taking of drugs. We need guidance to know that these drugs will harm us unless it is for medical reasons. We need guidance in our social life to know that gambling is a curse and that any wealth that we have should be given for the creator of the heavens and the earth. We need guidance in all aspects. The ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam needs husnul hidayah in this special time, this critical time. Imam Ash-Shawkani rahimahullah also looked at this verse, this furqan, in another light, which is so important to us. He said, it is a najat min kulli ma takhafuna. It is an escape from all that you are afraid of. So if we are afraid of the powers of this world, if we are afraid of not having wealth, if we are afraid of death, then the consciousness of Allah protects us and gives us the best guidance. So we pray that Allah would give this to us in this month, and we pray that Allah would accept our fasting. I leave you in peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.